Why is it that your core data-driven app crashes whenever you release a new version? It has to do with optionals, right? Well, actually, no. More often than not, it's about versioning of your data model. And the chances are you're most probably not even using core data versioning. So today, let's demystify core data versioning. Of course, there's a lot more to core data than versioning. There's also mapping, and we are going to cover that in this video. So make sure to check out this till the end. But besides mapping, there's a lot more about core data. Make sure to check out the link in the description if you want to learn about SwiftUI and core data inside SwiftUI camp. Link is in the description. So today I'm going to demystify core data versioning and mapping. Let's start off with a brand new Xcode project. So let's name this. Make sure that here the interface is set to SwiftUI, and I'm going to check use core data. We are not going to build out our model or our fetch request. For that, you have SwiftUI camp. Let's click on the next right over here. And let's put it anywhere that you please on your computer. And let's get rid of our canvas. And here it is. Let's just build and run. And basically what you get here is a core data versioning data model. It has an item, it has a timestamp right over here. And if you build and run, you will see that if I click right over here, it's just going to add in these timestamps, and we can just navigate to those detail views for those elements. And basically that's it. We also have our persistence set up, and inside our content view, we have this navigation view with a list, with a for each, toolbar item for all those two toolbar item buttons, and adding a button, it's right over here. We're going to cover also this in a bit, and then delete items if you choose to, then you can do so. So yeah, what I'm going to do right now is just delete these items. So let's just swipe and delete, swipe and delete. Okay, so let's just stop this. And let's say this is a good version for your application, but I also want to add some categories. So this is already on the App Store. It works really, really great. So let's add some categories to these items. Did you know that the average development time for an app is 7 months? Did you know that the hardest tasks in app development are persistence and backend? And did you know that 80% of bugs are actually UI bugs? Now imagine a framework that reduces development time by 70%, persists data in one line of code and syncs it with a backend automatically, and has zero UI bugs. Well, you don't have to imagine that anymore, because that framework already exists. It's called SwiftUI. For persistence, you got core data. For the backend, iCloud. If you want to code with zero UI bugs, see the link in the description. How to do that? Well, you want to create a new version. What you want to do is just select your core data model, go to editor. I know you can't really see it, but it will be there. And then add model version. So editor, add model version. And as you can see, it's just going to add core data versioning, the name of your core data model, and append it a 2 right over here, which is fine. So let's click on finish right over here. And now what happened? Well, you need to expand your core data versioning model dictionary, because yes, it's actually a dictionary. It has the initial core data versioning model, but now it has 2 of them. As you can see, here is core data versioning number 2. So this is the one that we are going to work in. So you can just go ahead and select any of those to make sure that, okay, these are different ones. But let's just check out number 2. And right over here, I'm just going to add a new category item, attribute, sorry. And let's just make that as a string. Okay, that's fine. We have that running. So now let's kind of solidly commit our changes. So what you want to do, again, make sure that either of these are selected. And in the attributes inspector, you want to go and select, first of all, you want to select what's this called file inspector. And then under the model version, you want to select the current version for your model. And that is number 2. So now just check that. And you can see, I don't know if you can, you know, if you really, really squeak your eyes right over here, you will see that that green check mark just moved onto our second model. Okay, so now if we build and run, Basically, it should be fine, but how can we add that category onto the onto our view? So what I'm going to do right over here is under the text, I'm going to create a V stack, and I'm going to have an alignment here for our leading, and let's add that text in there, and I'm going to add my category right over here. So text and item and category. So item dot category. And this is optional, so I'm just going to need to give a default value for it. Let's have a foreground color of gray for this and a font of caption. There we go. So now when we are creating a new item, we should add a new category. So right over here with add item, we just give a timestamp of our current date. We also want to go new item dot category equals some sort of a string. Let's make this a food, whatever, you know, it's just one category. So now let's build and run. And now it's using actually our core data versioning 2 for our data model. So let's click on plus right over here. And as you can see, it just added food. Let me just stop this and build it run. So you can see that, yeah, actually it persisted right over here. It's really nice. Okay, so let's just delete this because we are going to move even further. Now, as you can see, we have our version 1 right over here without that category, version 2 with that category. And if you release this to the App Store, this will be fine. Yeah, most probably in this particular case, it will be fine because Core Data will know how to map your data from one version to the next one. But if you want a little bit more complex, you know, data changes, then you will need to create a map. So first of all, let's create a new version. So again, under editor, add model version. So make sure that you are inside your core data model. Otherwise, the editor will show other stuff. And now we are going to create a version called 3 and based on model 2. So let's click on finish right over here. We have that version 2 added, you know, as version 3. And what I want to do right now is just change that category because usually you don't want to use the category inside that item. That's where relationships come in. So let's create a new entity. Let's add that entity right over here. And yeah, make sure that you are on core data version 3 right now, versioning 3. And let's name this category. Okay, we have our category right over there. And let's add a new attribute called maybe name, and let that be a string. Okay, so now what I want to do is just delete this category, the attribute and the, you know, the type of string, and let's add a relationship. So let's add a relationship. An item may have one category and a category might have multiple items. So here we are going to add category. Okay, and that would the destination would be category, and under category we are going to add a new relationship of items because we will have many items. The destination will be item, the inverse will be category. And one final thing, this is not one to many relationship, it is one it is not one to one, it is a one to many relationship. So what I want to do is just go ahead and change the type too many. So this is how you would just read it. Category has many items, M for many items. Item has one category, O for O. So we have set up our new database. This is fine. So let's create a map for this. So what you want to do is just create a map. So let's just create a new file right over here and scroll a little bit down to core data, and you see we have a mapping model. So let's click on next right over here. Let's select the initial one. So where are we mapping from? And that's version 2. Let's click on next, and where are we migrating to? Let's version 3. Okay, let's click on next again, and make sure that you create a nice name for this, something like this. Okay, let's create that. There we go, we created our map right over here. And now what you want to do is just go, so for example, let's just take a look at this. So we have item to item. which means that item version 2 to item version 3. And here we have the timestamp attribute, and it will just go $source.timestamp. So the timestamp will remain the same. And as you can see, Xcode is really smart about this. Now, what about the category? Well, we have a name. So what are we going to link that name to? Well, if you just go and open up the inspector right over here, you see we have source right over here. And what you want to do is just select item. And then under the value, you are just going to type out $source and dot and category. Now, what did we just do right over here? First of all, we made sure that we are linking to the item. And then on the value expression, we are telling that version 3 of the category name has to come from version 2 items category. Yes, make sure that you pause, rewind, and take a look at that again. Now, that's about the attributes. What about the relationships? Well, you want to select items, and right over here, under the key path, you want to add in $source. There we go. And then on the mapping name, you want to select item to category. Okay, and that's it. That's all you have to do. Now we want to move our core data current model to version 3. Let's just select version 3. And now we need to do some changes. So if we build and run, let's hit Command B, we will see some errors. And let's take care of them. So first of all, the item does no longer have a category. It does have a category, but it is not a string. So what it has have is a category dot name. So you just add dot name and you get that string right over there. And finally, here, when we are adding a category to the new item, we want to create a new category. Well, most probably you are going to create a new category somewhere else, not when you add a new item and then you just reference that category. But for this tutorial's sake, I'm just going to create a new category. So category equals category with a context of our view context, and I'm going to say category.name equals that food. And finally, I'm going to link that category with the new items category. That's category. Please remember, now this category is no longer a string. It is a reference to our one-to-one object for our category. So let's build and run one final time and let's see how this looks like. Okay, so now if we just add it right over here, we have our food, which is really nice. We just go in there, it's really nice. We have our food category. And now if you just sort through fruit, then you just have all of these or other categories, of course. So yeah, that is how you manage versioning. And if you want to learn more about core data inside SwiftUI, go ahead and check out the link in the description about SwiftUI Camp and make sure that you check out my previous video on how to read code perfectly. Go ahead and check it out. It's right over here.